Hey everyone, this is Manly Badass Hero, and welcome to Dead Secret. Dead Secret is a mystery horror game, where without spoiling too much, you essentially explore this house and try to figure out what happened.
Harris Bullard was found dead in his study 5 days ago. Nobody believes me, but I think he was murdered. This house in the middle of nowhere holds the secret. There's a story hiding here, and I'm going to cover it. If I'm right, there are 4 major suspects. Graham Wellington, Josie Herrera, Cynthia Peckman, Bobby Sawyer. I'm not leaving until I find out what happened.
Starts like Clue. That's weird. Oh, so you don't actually control yourself manually, it's point and click all the way. They sure aren't wasting any time selling off Bullard's stuff. An old piano, it's blocking the way. Alright, in and out, easy. Just have to find some evidence and get out of here. So can I zoom in on this? Not very easily. Well, it apparently jots down the clue from the file you get, so that helps. Retired recluse, found dead in his study, police ruled death natural, and Bobby Sawyer ran errands, found the body. Let's see. Assistant, ex-wife, inheritor, former colleague. A small parcel tied tightly with twine. You really can't open it with your bare- oh, we got a cast. See, key. Investigate the crime scene. Nothing there. Why is there weird Japanese seals? Oh, use the key automatically, that's nice. There's no masks. Died here, obviously. This is where Bobby Sawyer found Bullard's body. It's been dead for a couple of days, though. Got a note here? I wish there was a way to zoom in. As far as I know, I don't think there is. The Snow Woman. Oh, I actually know this story. It's from Lafcadio Hearn. Very famous Japanese horror writer. Wrote a lot of yokai stories. I'm not gonna actually read this thing, like you can freeze it or not, but it's just an excerpt, essentially from the story, and it's about, one of those Snow Woman yokai. Actually, no, it's actually the entire story, it's a short story. Dictionaries and language reference, it looks like. A lot of these books aren't even English. Where in the world did this murder happen? Issues of the journals, physiology, and a bunch of medical names I can't pronounce. Little clay statue. One appears missing. Butterfly. Top left of the butterfly wing. What can we find over here? A note with a foreign symbol. Underneath it reads North. Harris Buller, I am Woodcutter. Your past has caught up with you. It is over. Who's this Woodcutter? Woodcutter's threatening Bullard. Scissors, great. What's this? It looks like a tiny camera lens. Joe, something is after me. It's creeping around the house, trying to get in. I'm sure of it. I heard footsteps outside and creaking on the roof. It's not safe here. I've taken the ideofocal lenses from their normal location and hidden them in my study, which I have found. I've sent you a package that you'll know what to do with. Check the map for the mask. As usual, X marks a spot. The sequence is west, east, north. West, east, north. Let's go. What was that? Someone knocking on the windows? Hello? Mr. Crow. Mr. Crow. It's all good. B or right mouse for inventory. Objectives. Okay. So we can look at collected documents. It's not completely... It's an old book. Oh, it's never left Cadio's books. Went on. This guy was a fan of him. I actually have his entire book collection myself, to be honest, because I'm a huge weeb. Let's go back in here. What's wrong with the TV? Let's just walk right over the crime scene. That's weird. I could have sworn the TV was off before. It's a picture of a woman. She's wearing a white kimono and standing in the snow. There's something under the couch. There's a page from a manuscript here. The man who could see with his skin. In 1926, I met a man who could see with his skin. His eyes were sealed with wax and bandage, and he remained aware of the room around him. We held up signs, which he read, and fingers, which he counted, even when we stood behind him. After the performance, I gave him $200 for the secret. He explained that he could see as long as some part of his skin remained exposed to the air. He described it as a shift in the wind or a slight breeze on his face, the subtle motion of the hair on his arm. After years of focus and practice, he had developed the ability to form a mental image of his surroundings based only on these slight sensations. The man had achieved a form of idiophocus, like the lenses we got. Granted, he had only access to a very narrow range of sensory information, but the result was powerful. I immediately resolved to discover the secret of his ability. Now, almost 4 decades later, I am very close. Eyeless Joe found dead in a hotel. Something about this painting makes me feel very uncomfortable. So right now, we have books from Lefkadi O'Hearn, if I'm pronouncing his name fully right. And the first one we saw was about the, I think it's called... I forgot what the yokai's name was specifically. But like I said, it's a snow yokai. He marries this girl. He eventually reveals a secret he promised not to tell to his wife, and it turns out that's her. And she spares him because they have kids together. I got two lenses. Alright, let's check out over here, actually. It kind of feels like they were looking at me. What did they see in this room? Pretty advanced degrees. Quantum mechanics. The irony is, I also have my quantum mechanics books next to my Lefkadi O'Hearn books. It's a weird coincidence. There's no keyhole. I keep hearing weird noises and that bothers the hell out of me, let me tell you. It really bothers me. The X is over Japan. It has a kind of butterfly shape. Feels like it's hitting something. Wait, there's something jammed way back there. It's a flat triangular wedge. Some sort of foreign writing. A wooden wedge. Okay. Maybe I put the wedge on this. Ah, you push the pan on the globe. Should figure that. That's a small box. Let's get a better look at it on the desk. Alright, we have the button. Okay, we gotta use the code in the document where it was. West, east, north. So here, this shows us that one is north. So if this is north, that means this is east. West, east, north. Okay, that's... It's like a pair of weird goggles. I got the monkey mask. And the monkey around. I can see into the other side. Hello? You're the guy who got murdered, aren't you? Who was that? But it showed something on this painting. There's a page taped to the back. Josie, if you're reading this note, then something must have happened to me. I may be dead or missing. If so, you're the only person who can save our research. The truth is that I'm being threatened. It started before I left the college. I get notes every few months from somebody calling himself a woodcutter. What he wants is access to our research. He wants me to turn over our plans for the Lunar Dream Apparatus. That's a mouthful. Josie, my life is in danger. Woodcutter knows things, secret things about my past that nobody should know. I'll not yield to simple blackmail, but lately, the threats have escalated. I am sure that I am being watched in the house. I sometimes hear things on the other side of the wall. Yesterday, with the mask on, I thought I saw somebody reaching for me. It's a warning for my subconscious. I am no longer safe here. I've locked our research away in the safe upstairs. I want you to retrieve it and leave. Destroy everything before you go. Burn the house down if you have to. Just get the research and get out of here. Head for a big city where it's easy to hide. I'm counting on you, Joe. Don't let our work fall into their hands. Primary suspect? Probably not. Whatever Bullard was mixed up in, I bet there's evidence in that safe. Who is Woodcutter? Open the safe upstairs. This door was locked, so let's leave this area. Better stop and review my notes. Okay. Bobby Sawyer, right? Certainly on the opportunity. His secret research. Must have been killed for it. The Snow Woman. Anonymous. Well, kinda. Woodcutter. What is that supposed to mean? This is the kind of juicy detail I came here to find. Let's check the evidence out. Hopefully we're not jumped on the way up. I know you can't die in this game. Careful, don't get pushed down the stairs. I see shadows. Left or right? Right is always right. Right? You know, I think this is where the shadow went, but... Shh, be careful. B be careful. Fireplace is full of logs. Plate with a circular dial. What the fuck?
It might say reporter on my desk, but I spend most of my time at the Standard making coffee for my editor. I'm tired of writing the gossip column. This story is my shot at the big leagues. When I prove that Bullard was murdered, all the big papers will come calling. I'll finally escape this backwater town. This is it. The chance I've been waiting for.
What does it do with a handprint? Someone knocked over this lamp and it was plugged in recently. Check the goggles, huh? Pieces of a torn up photo. There. Right there. Right there. Right there. I guess it wants me to get it perfect. It's an old photo of two men on a ship. James Lowry and Harris Bullard. Monkey goggles. Oh, hi! There's something over there, boy? Harris Buller, I am Woodcutter. I know your secret. James Lowry sends his regards. For the watch. Well, the safe is up here. Bullard's Ben. We did a test run of the ideofocal lenses today. At first, we did not know how to interpret the results. But now I believe they are working better than we had anticipated. Instead of an unfiltered stream of sensory information, what we are seeing is subconscious memory. The lenses distort in response to visual stimuli that the wearer has some knowledge of. They see what my conscious mind cannot. Josie proposed that what we are really doing is mining dreams. Dreams are, after all, a form of ideofocus, a time when the subconscious comes forward and shows us truths that we may not otherwise recognize. What we are striving for is unrestricted access to dream thought. As a control mnemonic. I'll come back to it. The mask works pretty well. I could tell that Josie was dubious at first, but now she understands. Subconscious thought is potentially dangerous to the subject. We will need a physical object to enable the mind to compartmentalize, providing the wearer with some degree of cognitive protection. A permanent augmentation of monkey mask will require a much larger apparatus. We will need some other kind of focus, there's that word again, to help the brain control the deluge of dream information it will receive. Something large and ubiquitous. The moon, perhaps. Alright, let's check out over here. Nothing here. Maybe he's gonna give us the clue of how to open this thing, or he's just gonna murder us. Hey, buddy. We need to figure out how to open this safe. And not get murdered in the process. Find the safe combination. Let's go back to the other room. Monkey Mask. He's at the chest. Okay. Not much of interest. Hero says helicopter may yet win Vietnam War. All right. Nothing in there. We'll get this note. We'll obviously need that. What do we have here? Dear Diary, today is an anniversary. It was 5 years ago today that I found Dad's name on an old research paper at the U of C. He had written it in 1933, 8 years before I was born. I didn't know he had gone to college. I'd never really thought about his life. He was just a name on my birth certificate. Dad ran out on Mama after the war. He had gone off to fight and just never came back. When he stopped writing, Mama thought he'd been killed. I remember her crying at the kitchen table. The war ended. Life went on. Mama died without ever finding out what had happened to him. I used to hate him. Hated the idea of him. Hated my mother a little bit, too. I figured Dad was just a deadbeat who ditched Mama because he didn't want a kid. But when I found his name in the library, something changed. I couldn't stop thinking about him. Deadbeat dads don't study physics, do they? What is he doing now? What does he look like? Is he married to somebody else? I traced him here to Kansas, but finding him is taking longer than I had expected. Found something here. Bobby, here is your latest chapter all typed up. I think this story is becoming very interesting, and I'm sure you can get it published. I hope you don't mind, but I made a few edits and inserted a few details here and there. I'm looking forward to your next chapter, Joe, at Crystal Cave. Detective Henderson. They found the way to the cave by mapping a body. Let's check my files. So we have you. So, you are probably related to Mr. Harris Bullard. For some reason, you left the original wife. You came and found him, decided to help in the research. Graham Wellington. Don't know much about anyone else here. I see those ravens.
Bill told me to cover Bullard's death, but he's just looking for gossip about the young assistant. But I took it seriously, did the research, followed every lead, like a real journalist would. It paid off. I found something everybody else missed. A note, a half-thought, scribbled in the margins of the coroner's draft report. It read, "Hypothermia in summer?"
Weird. All right. I have exactly what we need. Now we gotta make the symbol right there. This is actually a crest, old family crest from Japan. Small wooden knob that opens the thing downstairs. Dear Diary, today Mr. Bullard and I built a chassis for this new weather device. It's weird as usual. I don't really get why we're building it, but Dr. Bullard doesn't explain things. Tomorrow I need to go buy some bottles for the base. Today was Mama's birthday. She would have been 54. I bet she would have liked the work I'm doing now. I hope she's proud somewhere. I had the nightmare again last night. It's been over a year since I had it last, but it never changes. I've written about it over and over, but the writing seems to help, so I'll tell you about it again. I'm 5 years old, in our apartment in Chicago. It's dark. I have gone out of bed to get some water, but I hear something coming from Mama's room. I peek in and see a tall man standing over her. He has his hands around her neck. He's breathing hard, and in the cold night air I can see his breath. It streams out of his mouth like smoke and seems to cover her. There isn't any breath coming from Mama. She's already dead, but he continues to squeeze. When I was a kid, I thought the dream would go away when I grew up. It hasn't.
What if the story of the Snow Woman... what if it's actually connected to what happened? Because I said hyperthermia
and his death.
And there is some kind of story here of maybe possibly two wives.
Crows? Let's leave.
Maybe he met a snow woman in Vietnam. Alright. Shit! Hide!
Don't find me.
God, this is a terrible hiding spot. Where else would I hide? Under the bed, probably. Shit, he's inside. No.
Just walk away, man. Just walk away.
Listen.
Dead end.
You got ending D. You suck.
Hide somewhere else. Chair.
Hide in the chair. This is a terrible hiding spot. Why did I think of this?
Shh, you'll never suspect a thing.
He's like, really? Really, buddy? Really?
Really? Really, buddy? I mean, I'm gonna murder you, but still, really?
Jump out the window!
Snow? Why am I in snow all of a sudden? It's suddenly Japan in the snow. Afterlife? Okay, go where the light is on. Or go where the light is pointing, maybe. I mean, it's pointing this way. Unless it's where the dot is pointing. Yeah, it's the dot. Well, that doesn't make sense. The dot's pointing this way. Right? I see a light over there. Well, it's not that way. go where it's not pointing? I'm getting closer. I can feel it. Monkey. What is going on here? This is a freezer. Hi. Did I fail? Or are you here to save me? I don't think this is a good end. I'm okay. Alright, we can just go back inside. The man in the raincoat was at the woodcutter. Leave. Run away. Must have hit my head. So that's one ending option, I guess. So there probably an ending right there where I could have gone just by leaving. Dr. Bullard, I followed your instructions to calibrate the Tempest prognosticator. Your concern was correct. The balls must be placed from the heaviest to lightest to produce accurate results. The actual weight depends on the leech used, so I have to recalibrate every time we want to take a reading. Also note that recalibration is required if the battery in the base dies. However, the device works as intended. Once the model is aligned precisely with the moon, it may then be used to start the lunar dream apparatus safely. Gotta solve a puzzle.